was August in 1814, along the Chesapeake Bay. The British had taken Washington and set fire to the White House that day. Along the mouth of the Potomac, in a sloop named the Benjamin B, was a man by the name of Francis Scott on his way to set a friend free. Now the British were at that river, and they took his boat in tow, and said, when we've captured McHenry's flag, we'll be glad to let you go.
15 bars and 15 stars flying in the wind, over Fort McHenry's stone, waving like a friend. The red, the white, the battle blue, and the star-spangled sky, standing for a nation where men could live free lives.
British troops landed at North Point to hit McHenry's flank as the Navy set up rockets along the riverbank. Up the Patapsco River, the Union Jack did sail. They had a message for Old Glory, flying bombs were what they made. 1,800 bombs were sent deep into the night. Francis Scott was worried, his flag was lost from sight. The morning of the 14th, that silence finally fell. The British powder had done its worst, now the dawning light would tell. Through the mist and the drizzle, a lonely figure stood on deck, staring speechless. His heart was still as wood. A smile reached his lips as the dawn light revealed the flag, the flag had withstood the rain of smoke and steam.
15 bars and 15 stars flying in the night, over Fort McHenry's stone, through the raging fight. The red, the white, the battle blue, and the star-spangled night, stood proudly for a nation where freedom was a right.
In his heart, Scott felt a feeling, fire-deepened pride. And on the pages of a loved one's letter, he wrote what he felt inside. The words came quickly